In this example, I have a client-side application that logs in with Google and is provided a one-time use auth code. The client sends this auth code off to my server, in which in turn communicates with Google in order to exchange the code for an authorization token. The client then sends off this code to my server, which in turn communicates with Google in order to exchange the code for an access token. If the exchange is successful, then I create my own token which I can send back off to the client to authenticate with my application. Let's start by registering our application with Google in order to get a client ID. We can download our credentials into a JSON file our code can then point to. A more detailed walkthrough is provided in the instructor notes. Now in the code, let's start by refactoring my user model to take advantage of some of the profile information I can get from my OAuth access token. A user's name, email, and profile picture can be easily obtained with OAuth, so I will add these fields now. I can look up users by their unique email addresses, so I will index my database based on emails as well. Now, in my views.py, I will add a new endpoint called /OAuth/provider that responds to a post request. We will first get the one-time auth code if the provider parameter is set to Google. Then we will take this auth code and send it off to Google in exchange for an access token. Once I have successfully received an access token from Google, I can use it to send an API request to Google to get my user's information. I will look up a user based on the provided email address from the Google API. If a user exists, I will retrieve that user object. Otherwise, I will just make a new user object and store their information in my database. Now that I have a user object, I can generate an auth token to allow that user to access protected endpoints without having to provide a username and password. And since this course doesn't focus on creating the client-side application that will send off this authorization code, I have added a template that signs into Google and displays the one-time auth code. View the instructor notes to see and play around with the code from this video.